All right. Happy Tuesday, guys. Hopefully, yesterday you got to review central idea, which is the same thing as main idea, and supporting details. You should have learned that information in elementary school. However, if you didn't, now you have notes to refer to on both central idea and supporting details. And today we're going to break apart an article and really look into paragraph by paragraph what are the central idea and supporting details of each paragraph. Sometimes when you're analyzing text, it is helpful to break it down by paragraph. This is something that we're going to be working with here throughout the next month or so in preparation for taking those PSSA tests. Okay, so let's take a look at our essential question. Still working with how to identify the central idea and supporting details of a nonfiction text. So, the first step we're going to do today is we're going to read the entire passage. And then, step two, I'm going to model for you finding the central idea and the supporting details of paragraph one. And then guess what? You will be working with the PowerPoint that's attached to complete the rest of the process. Okay, so let's go. All right. So here's our article. Our article today is called Hatching Success. It is actually from Time for Kids magazine. And yeah, it's from way back in 2008. Okay, so it's kind of an older article, but still very relevant. Okay, it says Hatching Success, a chicken farmer who got his start with a small loan gives back. And you can see here there's a storybook that has been written. Kind of telling the story of this man here. This whole article's about Quibina Dargo, and he is a chicken farmer. And so, here's a picture of him. So let me just read this out loud to you. When Quibino Dargo was a boy growing up in Ghana, that's in Africa, his family was very poor. Every morning, he got up before sunrise to walk from door to door selling fruits and vegetables. It was for survival, Darko told Time for Kids. I had to do the work to get something on the table. Today, Darko is a successful businessman. He owns one of the largest farms in West Africa and employs hundreds of people. He worked hard to come so far, but he says, I would never have been where I am without the help of a small loan. 40 years ago, when Darko needed money to start his chicken farm, it was not easy to get a loan. He went to the bank and asked to borrow money but was turned away. Dargo refused to give up, and eventually his persistence paid off. He was loaned a small sum of money to purchase his first 900 chickens. By selling the chickens' eggs, he was soon able to pay the bank off. From there, his business took off. Dargo never forgot how that loan changed his life. Working with Opportunity International, he has given out small loans to more than 100,000 people in Ghana. His clients have started bakeries, dress shops, and schools for local kids. One Hen, a new picture book based on Darko's story, hit stores this month. Author Katie Smith Milway wants kids to understand that a small loan and one person can make a big difference. Children today have much more of a sense of the needs in the world, she says. It's important to give them some answers and some ways to help. And this article was written by Suzanne Friedman. Okay. So basically, this passage is a pretty short article written on this chicken farmer. So let me just stop here. All right. So we are going to break this down paragraph by paragraph. Okay. So I'm going to stick this over here. So let's reread the first paragraph, and I'm going to model for you how to fill out the graphic organizer on each of the slides of the PowerPoint here. So, when Quibino Darko was a boy, his family was very poor. Every morning, he got up before sunrise to walk from door to door selling fruits and vegetables. It was for survival, Darko told Time for Kids. I had to do the work to get something on the table. All right, so The first thing we're going to do is pick out the supporting details. Remember, all the supporting details add up and help us to figure out what the main idea is, okay? So that's the logical place to start. So it says he got up early and walked door to door selling fruits and vegetables. So that's one supporting detail. Another supporting detail is that it was to survive. It says here it was for survival, okay? So he had to do this to survive. And he had to work hard to feed the family. Here it says he had to work to get something on the table. That means to put food on the table, which means if he didn't work, they wouldn't eat, okay? So putting all of this together, all of these details, this tells me that the main idea of this first paragraph is that Darko was poor, so he had to work to survive. So your main idea should just be one statement, one short statement, a couple of words to a sentence, okay? So keep that in mind as you continue to work through this document, okay? So remember when we were analyzing poetry and we would take it stanza by stanza and write in the margins, okay? So this main idea is basically doing that just on a deeper level where we're actually picking out the supporting details and coming up with that main idea, okay? So let me go ahead here and show you what you're going to be doing. So you're going to be rereading the remainder of the passage paragraph by paragraph. So open up then the attached assignment where you're going to have my example slide for paragraph one. You don't need to do anything to that. The answers are already on there for you. Start with slide two, which would be paragraph two of the article, and you're going to work your way through the next four slides, okay? Completing the graphic organizer for each paragraph. I've taken some of the boxes out. If they don't have three supporting details, just fill in the boxes that are there. Then the very last slide, okay, you're gonna see if you can figure out the central idea of the entire article. So you might wanna go back then and read through all of the main ideas, okay, from each paragraph, it's only five, and then see if you can come up with what you think the entire article's central idea or main idea is, and type it in that very last slide, okay? And we're gonna go over this when you come back to class on Thursday, okay? So if you have any issues, please reach out to me. If not, great, and I will get to see you on Thursday. Have a great day.